Hi, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to render a QuickTime movie out of After Effects. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that your render comp or your final comp is selected and your work area is set from 0 to the end of wherever, however long you want to render your movie. So we have that set. We are good to go. We're going to go to Composition, Add to Render Queue. And so our render queue is opened up. And I have an old render, so I'm going to delete that. You want to make sure that you're on your render settings, that it just says best settings. That's your default. If it's not defaulted, you want to make sure that that is on. And then for your output module, go ahead and click on lossless, and this will open up our output module settings. Right now I have QuickTime selected, and that looks good. If we go to format options, click on that. The default is animation, quality 100%. This is going to result in a long render and a very large file. So don't use that. What you want to do is do either H.264 or photo JPEG. Either one. A photo JPEG is going to be a little bit, the file size is going to be a little bit bigger. The quality is going to be pretty decent. For the purpose of this tutorial, we're going to do H.264, and this is good enough for if you're uploading to YouTube or just using like web quality, it's pretty decent. You can keep your quality at 100%. I usually do 75 or 80. It still looks good, and the file size is a little smaller. We're going to click OK, and we're going to make sure our video output is checked, and it is. Our size is 1920 by 1080, that's HD. If you wanted to resize that, you can always select that box and you can select another default or another setting. You can also, you can check 720 if you wanted that to be smaller, but we're gonna keep it as is. And if you're using After Effects CC2012, like I am, or 2014, your output audio is set to on. It used to be, or output audio is set to auto. So if there's a audio track, it's gonna render with audio. You can also select off if you didn't want an audio track on your video. If you're using an older version of After Effects, there will be a checkbox just like there's on the video output. And you'll wanna make sure that checkbox is selected. But for the newer versions, it's just automatically on, which is nice. So click okay. And our next option is our output to. So this is where we want to output, and you'll just select, we're just going to do the desktop, and of course you want to name it. And click OK. It works a little bit faster for me if you close the comp viewer, close that, or if you had it open and put the caps lock key on. And that actually saves you a little bit of time, because if you have those windows open, when you're rendering, you're going to see each frame being processed. And if you close that window, you're actually saving yourself some time and saving After Effects the time of processing and showing you each rendered frame, which you don't need to see because you're just making a QuickTime movie. We're gonna close that window or that panel and go back to your render queue. And then you're ready to render and click the render button. And just a quick note, if you're rendering a template that's heavy on the animation, as After Effects is rendering your QuickTime movie, your estimated remaining time in your render queue will change. All you can do is just sort of wait it out and see how long it'll take. Sometimes something that's rather complicated will take a few hours, and that's totally normal. A simpler project like the one that we're rendering right now, it's just fade in and fade out, just simple editing, that's going to render rather quickly, or a lot quicker than something with a lot of 3D, a lot of 3D lighting and motion blur, etc. So now when our render is done, you can go to the render queue and twirl down the output module, and you can select this yellow link or this line, and this will open up the window where your render ended up. So here it is, render 2015. You can double click to open that up. And there we have it. If you ever have any other questions, you can always email me. My email address is marissa@fluxvfx.com, and I'll be happy to answer any of your questions.